Professor Dr. Prakash Savanke from Walchand Institute of Technology. Today we are going to discuss the topic study of comparators. It is from the metrology subject. At the end of this session, students will describe the meaning, role and classification of comparators. They will be able to explain principle of working of comparators. Introduction to comparators. First, what do you understand by the word comparator? What do the word comparator signifies? Yes. Comparator means it is an instrument which is used to compare the dimension of component with a working standard. So it basically compares with the standards and measures the deviation. So it indicates a deviation from the expected or basic dimension. Now this expected or basic dimension is set in the form of some standard. So comparator will not give the direct value of the say dimension, but it will measure the deviation from it. Normally the deviation is small and hence it needs magnification. So it is magnified in comparator. It is widely used in mass production because of its merits and over measuring instruments as well as limit gauges. So let us see what are the merits of comparators. Measuring instruments, if we consider, they need skilled operator to use. So you might have seen vernier caliper or micrometer. So they need skilled operator, so who can read, do the adjustment. So it consumes more time for the measurement. And because of which they are not suitable in mass production. However, one advantage of measuring instrument is that, so they give the values of the, quantity that is being measured or the dimension that is being measured, so which become useful in data, so that is useful, they provide useful data which is needed for statistical process control or statistical quality control. So both. So this is as far as the measuring instruments. If we consider the limit gauges, which are used normally in case of mass production, they are simple to use and they don't need skilled operators. They are fast and economical and become useful in mass production. However, say they check whether the component lies within the limits, maximum and minimum. So only that is checked. So they will not give any value, any data, any reading, so which can be used or which is necessary in case of SPC or SQC. So that is not provided. So comparators combine advantages of both. They can work as limit gauges for fast operation in mass production with unskilled operator, and whenever needed, say that deviation can be measured and data becomes useful, say for SPC. So that data is provided, say, with the help of this comparators. So we can find actual dimension also, say, by adding or subtracting the deviation from the standard value. So that is the advantage. So if we consider the applications of comparator, basically they can be used as laboratory standards. So in tool rooms and the controlled atmosphere, so they will be used for calibration of the gauges. So they act as a laboratory standards. Secondly, they can also be used as working gauges, and even they can be used as limit gauges by setting the limits of the for the deviation, maximum and minimum. So they can be used as working gauges. Similarly, final inspection at the time of assembly or after the assembly for final checking of the products, so that can be comparators can be used. Comparators can also be used as receiving inspection gauges for the material or the components which is coming, say, from outside in the industry, say, which is bought out components as well as raw materials. And say it can also be used for calibration of new gauges, so that are manufactured. So in that case, that act as a standard for the calibration. Requirements of good comparator. So what are the, requirements, or what are the characteristics that are required for the comparators? Basically, first, say it should have a robust design and construction, because it is used widely, and in case of mass production in industry. So because of the wide use, it needs robust design. Secondly, linearity of scale. So that is always expected of any measuring instrument, it is the same. Third important is high magnification. Basically, comparators are measuring the deviation from the standard, so which will be having a very small amount. If in case of dimension, it will be in microns. So it cannot be indicated directly, so it needs magnification. Next is fast operation. Since we have to use it in mass production, say when thousands or millions of components are being produced, so they must be checked fastly, so fast operation. One more thing is versatility and flexibility. So the same comparator can be used to check variety of dimensions or variety of measurements and variety of components. So there should be scope for adjusting, say, that particular sensing element and some clamping and all at this arrangement, so that variety type of dimensions and variety type of components can be accommodated. Of course, for any product, durability is one of the common requirements, so that is also expected in, say, for a good comparator. And environmental stability, because say there will be going to variety of environments. As the season changes, temperature will be changing, humidity will be changing, so many things, dust particles. So environmental stability, so that should be there, so that is expected, then only a comparator will be really useful, say, for working in the industry. Now, classification of comparators. Comparators are classified based on the method that is used for magnifying and recording the deviation measured. So the majority of the groups in which, say, comparators are classified are as follows. One is mechanical, another is optical, then third is pneumatical, then electrical, / electronic, magnetic, then combined, such as electromechanical, mechano-optical, etc. Then multi-check. So simultaneously, there can be number of dimensions that can be checked. So that is also possible. So then that kind of comparator is multi-check. Then automatic gauging. So nowadays with help of the computers and other, microprocessors. So automatic gauges has become possible. So in mechanical comparators, mechanical means are used for magnification and recording. So that is mechanical. In case of optical, it is optical principles. In case of pneumatical, it will be pneumatical principles. Likewise, electrical principles, magnetic principles, etc. And according to that, say the classification is done. Normally, if we consider the working and use of comparators, say normally first selecting the dimensions to be measured, and accordingly appropriate standard has to be set. Second step is determination of tolerance limit. So what is the maximum deviation and what is the minimum deviation from this standard? So that is expected. So that has to be determined. The next stage is initial setting zero for standard dimension. So what is expected size, expected dimensions for that some standard, which might be in the form of standard component or it might be slip gauges. So that is set and then sensing element, normally it may be some kind of spindle stylus, so that is touched to it, and say for this initial setting, 0 is adjusted. Then the standard is replaced by the components that are to be measured, say one by one, then recording the deviation from the standard, which could be positive, negative, or 0. If the component that is measured is having greater size than the standard, then say there will be a positive deviation. If it is having a smaller size, there will be negative deviation. If it is exactly equal, then it will be 0. So then we can calculate the actual dimension if necessary. Then one more possibility is that setting the maximum and minimum limits on the dial and use it as a limit gauge. So you can set the maximum and minimum limits, and if the component is deviation is lying within the limits, we can accept it. If it is going outside, then reject it. So there is no need to even record the deviation when we are using the comparator as a limit gauge. So that is working as a limit gauge. So if we see general elements of the comparator, so there are normally sensing element. So it will sense the, displacement or deviation. Then second is transmission. The sense deviation may be transmitted. Then there may be transducer. The element may be converted into another variable if needed. Then there is a magnification or amplification, say that is needed, and finally display of the deviation. So these are the general components of any kind of transducers. The reference for this material is taken from the textbook of metrology by M. Mahajan, Dhanpat Rai and Company Private Limited. So we end our preliminary discussion on the comparators here.